friends, I'm Dharmala Shri from Smart Leaders IAS. So this article, we are going to discuss the editorials which came on February 7th. It is about two articles. One is about protectionism and other one is about Brexit. So let us move on to the article now. So what will be the UPSC focus areas may be era of globalization or the globalization 2.0, the globalization versus protectionism regionalism versus globalism, because so many regional trade architectures are evolving. So this can be an area of question. Or as if no, Asia is going more and more open, like China and India, they are more open towards in terms of trade or any other thing, whereas West is shutting its doors. So this can be an area of interest for UPSC. And the next may be America is walking down and as a leader of globalization, and this can be replaced by China. Whether China can be a new ambassador for globalization, these are the broad areas we can expect this year. So please prepare these areas. Let us move on to article. So what is this article about? Trump started thinking about rethinking of his protectionist policy. Recently in his speech in Davos, it reflected his idea of rethinking protectionist policy, because as one hand, he started doing in hardcore protectionist stance, like imposing more and more tariffs and penalties over other countries like China, South Korea and all. And whereas he is saying that America first is not America alone. So these two are like extreme contradictions. So how he is focusing, so this shows that Trump started rethinking his protectionist policy. So main crux of the article is his speech in Davos, that is America first is not America alone. Because he got so many criticism before his meet in Davos, because whether from our Indian Prime Minister or European Union leaders is like Angela Merkel or Chinese President Xi Jinping, everyone has slammed the protectionism in the global arena, and everyone wants the global to be more open. So he is changing his stance, like America first is not America alone in this situation. So now Trump started now he is very open to renegotiate a Trans-Pacific Partnership, which he walked out last year. So this shows that again rethinking of his protectionist stand. And the next one is he is revisiting NAFTA also. NAFTA, which is North American Free Trade Agreement. So this North American Free Trade Agreement, which comprises US, Canada and countries like Mexico. So now he is revisiting reforming NAFTA also, so that he can be a major player in NAFTA, replacing Canadian manufacturing companies like etc. So next is, what is his protectionism stand? So he is following very much protectionism against China, in term because he's accusing that China theft all his manufacturing jobs, all his place in the global market. So he started imposing penalties more than 45% on aluminium exports from Beijing, and he's accusing that China is a thefter, like intellectual property theft. It is a main condition China is using for trading with the other country. These are the allegations which Trump kept on China, and now China started moving towards the WTO to get its due. Also, apart from this, apart from his protectionist stand on China, he is facing some adversaries in his own country because of his protectionist policy. Because solar energy sector is a successful sector, which is expected to be more successful in future as well. Well, and US had a lot of opportunities in the solar manufacturing, but it is not facing its due share, mainly because of not getting cheap imports from China and other countries due to the Trump's protectionist stance. So it is not suitable for US itself. That is the hardcore protectionist stance. So next is, plastic washing machine is also getting in its hard hit in US because of competitors from South Korean companies like LG, Samsung, etc. So these are the pressures or forces which drives Trump to get to rethink his protectionism in this global situation, and what he is going to do will be watched by everyone. But however, whatever be his protectionist policy, it will have impact in the globalization, but whether it will be a setback for globalization, that is maybe on our area of interest in the writing examination. We will discuss now. So what can be the area? Because if he is following protectionist stand, China will retaliate by more aggressive trade deals. And there is another chance of revamping WTO in this present situation. So far, US is influencing WTO in terms of fund and in terms of members also. And it say in WTO, it was highly influenceable. But now with the policies of Trump, developing countries like India, they can raise their voice together and make a chance to reform WTO, like implementing Doha development rounds. So this can be, this is the right time and opportunity given to the developing countries to reform the WTO in a more by giving more equitable way. And the next one is new order, which can be emerged from isolation of US and togetherness of other countries like European Union and Asian countries, and even the other countries like African countries, etc. So isolation cannot be a rule anymore. So here a new order can be developed in our international relation. Next is bilateral things will not give its due share for Trump's negotiation with the world trade. So it can be a setback to Trump, and it will not give fulfillment to the Trump's policies. So it can be a setback for him. So regional trade negotiation has its own say hereafter, and because of his policies, protectionist stand, as I told you earlier, solar sector is getting its backlash because of his policy. So internal chaos will start emerging one or the other sector. So here, so protectionism, he wants to enforce, it cannot be continued or in his own period. So we can expect globalization can move forward, but because even we all know that globalization is a dynamic force, it can move forward rather than going backward, and with it so much of changing and adaptation to the present scenario. So we can expect localization rather than globalization and or localization alone. So it is a better time and right time to reform the globalization and making more equitable globalization and in this scenario. Let us move on to the next article, which is about Brexit. So Brexit, with respect to our examination point of view, from 2016, a Brexit referendum was conducted in Britain, and next to 2017, and court said that before triggering Article 50, that is official formal program which starts Brexit procedures from European Union, and a court told that parliamentary approval is necessary and must. So these are the conditions developments after Brexit started. An exam point of view, we can expect what is the relation, how is the post-Brexit and European relation can be, and what is the impact on India, what Brexit says to the globalization. Brexit and Trump in US can be seen as a protectionism in the whole West. So it is closing the doors in the West. So we can see the protectionism in the West and globalization in the East, as I told you earlier. So we can see these two areas, like Brexit and globalization. So let us move on to article now. This article, which came about the interview given by Gina Miller, she is a hardcore campaigner for Brexit, and he's a campaigner for so many issues, more than 20 years. So she says that it is not about exit of Britain, it is about saving Britain. So she says it more about saving Britain, not about Brexit. So she's Gina Miller, and she says that after the post-Brexit developments, we need to think for the future of Britain. And in so many wider ways, like immigration exposure and immigration process and the trade process, as in the businesses and the people, every other parts, like we need to discuss more in an open forum. And she is against that at parliamentary approval, because she believes that rather than the legislator point of view, people's view should be respected. So every aspect after post-Brexit solutions and discussions needs to be in a public forum. And the next one is about the there was a question which is about the second referendum, because so many debates and the discussions happened after Brexit, but whether the Brexit itself is a flawed decision or like that. So I'm asking the question about second referendum. She says that there is no need for a second referendum because people accepted that the Brexit is a reality. So now we need to move forward and make the Brexit process without less pain. Next one is, she says that we need to remain in Britain and leave the EU. So that is what we need to see. Now we see what is our examination related area, like Brexit impact on India. So what are the opportunities and what are the challenges? So far it is not asked in UPSC, but we can expect this area maybe in terms of business or India needs to do. We need to search France as a gateway to Europe or kind of thing. So we can expect this area. It is a classic topic for us. Almost 2-3 years we are expecting this area. So the first one, it is about the opportunities for opportunities because of Brexit to India. The first one is FTA. So a free trade agreement, we can deal with Britain separately, because so far we are trying so many rounds of talks with European Union in terms of free trade agreement, which is not getting consensus. So it was an area of question last year, or I think prelims or mains, I'm not sure about that. So there was a question asked in UPSC, and we can improve our service sector to a next level because we have the better say in the negotiation because of our English speaking advantage. And the next one is as of now, we are the second largest FDI inflow to the UK. So it will be further enhanced. So it is also an area of opportunity for India to continue business with the UK. And education, as of now, it is a high cost education area for Indian students to study higher studies. So now the cost of education can be reduced to an accepted standard. So these are the opportunities for us. Of course, there are so many concerns for us. Apart from this opportunity, we can see the concerns or challenges based on the Brexit, which is imposing on India. So we'll see the challenges also. So first one is regional uncertainty because of chaos which is developed on because of Brexit, or the kind of uncertainty which is developing in the other states, like whether European Union itself is a stable one or unstable one, because one after other will start walking out from the European Union, maybe other area of question or other area of concern and for us as well. And the next one is immigration norms may be tighter because main concern is refugee entry into UK was the main reason, and they cited when Brexit was campaigned. So immigration concern becomes one of our main concern. We are more towards a service sector and the people-to-people contact like we are engaging in. So it's a mode four of service, it is a biggest concern for us. And we need to search an alternative gateway to Europe because as of now, every European Union's head offices, like whether our IT sector companies or manufacturing companies, as we headquartered in UK, now we need to shift to other areas and we need to find a gateway to Europe via France or Germany, like any other countries. Okay. Prepare well. These areas can be an expected areas in the UPSC. All the very best. Thank you.